Some of you guys don't know this, but a chapter of SpaceX is about to end. I'm Lei. Let's talk about it today. In my mind, if someone were to write a book on the history of SpaceX, there will be three defining chapters. Chapter 1 is characterized by SpaceX's struggle to demonstrate its lower Earth orbit launch capabilities. Founded in 2002, SpaceX did not successfully launch anything to space until 6 years later. It was a very stressful era of SpaceX financially. Elon has to put in more than half of his personal fortune into the company with no expectations of return. $100 million. It was no joke, not for him. And lucky for all of us, the fourth launch of Falcon 1 was a total success. SpaceX survived. To me, that was the end of SpaceX's first chapter. It was life and death. SpaceX did it. Then we arrive at the second chapter of SpaceX, which is incidentally also the current chapter. This chapter is characterized by SpaceX's rapid tests and iterations to improve reusability of Falcon 9. Reusability is the holy grail of the 21st century space race. At least commercially, your rocket will be at a very disadvantaged position if it's not reusable. It's like throwing away a car every time you take a trip. This phase of SpaceX will end with the advent of two future events. The first one is the maiden launch of Falcon Heavy. The second one is the completion of Falcon 9 Block 5. This chapter is about SpaceX strengthening its capabilities, and this transition is also the focus of today's video. But for now, let's briefly talk about the third and the last chapter of SpaceX, which is obviously the Mars chapter. With the BFR being developed in the next decade, SpaceX will quickly become the single most powerful space company in the world. With the financial backing of NASA and SpaceX commercial launch customers, SpaceX will be able to really focus on the X part of its name, exploration. Chapter 3 is what we're all looking for, but for now, SpaceX is in its transition period between Phase 2 and Phase 3. So let's talk about this transition first. As I mentioned, this transition is marked by the completion of Falcon 9 Block 5 and the maiden launch of Falcon Heavy. Obviously, the launch of Falcon Heavy is highly anticipated. After years of patiently waiting, it's finally happening. So if you have any question regarding the maiden launch of Falcon Heavy, you should check out my previous video on that. It's pretty comprehensive, I think. I'll link it. Also, if you still have more questions regarding the launch after watching the video, tweet me at LeiCreatives. We'll take it from there. So the second thing that marks the end of the second chapter is the completion of Falcon 9 Block 5. But what is Falcon 9 Block 5? Basically, Falcon 9 Block 5 is going to be the final version of Falcon 9 and quite possibly the final version of Falcon Heavy, since Falcon Heavy is three Falcon 9 boosters strapped together. So you know it's significant. It's like telling you the next Star Wars movie is going to be the last addition to the Star Wars franchise, and you know it's going to have an epic ending. So how epic is Falcon 9 Block 5 going to be? Pretty epic, I think. But to understand it, we need to start with Falcon 9 Block 1. Over the years, Falcon 9 has evolved 4 times. Falcon 9 Block 1, Falcon 9 Block 2, Falcon 9 Block 3, and an internal upgrade to Falcon 9 Block 4. Falcon 9 Block 1 is commonly known as Falcon 9 version 1.0. Falcon 9 Block 2 is the version 1.1. Falcon 9 Block 3 and 4 falls under the name Falcon 9 Full Thrust. Shown on the screen are some of the key upgrades from each version. As you can see, over the years, Falcon 9s have gotten significantly bigger and more powerful. But this is not going to be the focus of the last and final upgrade. What Falcon 9 Block 5 is going to bring to the table is rapid reusability. The possibility of reusing a booster under 24 hours. This is very important because Falcon Heavy at its current level is already able to send the most demanding payload to any orbit it desires. Therefore, there is no point upgrading the vehicle for commercial launch services. It makes sense to stop. So let's take a look at the changes that's about to happen to the final version of Falcon 9. Reportedly, in the final version of Falcon 9, the total thrust will improve by 7-8%. So we're talking about around 68 tons of payload to the low Earth orbit. The flight control system will also improve so that the fuel requirement for landing will be lowered. This means more fuels to send bigger payloads to different orbits. Furthermore, major improvements will be made for rapid reusability. Redesigned landing legs, more temperature-resistant grid fins, and thermal protection and heat shield for most part of the rocket, especially the engines. This will ensure rapid reusability of the rocket. One more thing to note is that the Block 5 will also be the rocket that lifts manned Dragon 2 capsule to the International Space Station. All of the following events will happen for SpaceX in 2018. Sending its first manned mission to the International Space Station, first space tourist to the moon, first launch of Falcon Heavy, and on top of all of that, there will be more launches by SpaceX than ever in 2018. So no doubt, it's going to be an exciting year for SpaceX and an exciting year for all of us. But what we need to bear in mind is that this year is also going to be pivotal for SpaceX because it's finally transitioning from space part of its name to the exploration part of its name. And this is new to all of us. Ever since 2002, critics have always been saying that SpaceX's goal to colonize Mars is a publicity stunt. So 2018 will be a good year for SpaceX to prove itself. Maybe decades later, looking back, 2018 will be indeed the first year of its Mars chapter. Alright, thanks for watching. If you like this video, subscribe. If you have more questions regarding what I said in the video, tweet me at Lei Creatives and I'll be sure to give you a reply. And that's it for today. I'm Lei, I'll catch you guys in the next one.